إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين.
إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه. ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه أرسله بالهدى بين يدي الساعة بشيرًا ونذيرًا فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فصل اللهم عليه وسلم وبارك وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اقتفى أثره واهتدى بهديه إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "The similitude of my nation is that of rain. One does not know which is better, its beginning or its end." This is reported by Imam Tirmidhi and classed as authentic by Al-Imam Al-Albani. May Allah be merciful on all of them. This great narration puts hope in the hearts, motivates the person, the believer, to work and strive for the religion, and it strengthens and solidifies determination and willpower. There is no space for despair when we know that goodness is there in the Ummah. And Imam Al-Tibi Rahmatullahi alayhi commented saying, "The symmetry, or the similitude rather, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave is with respect to benefit. Rain is beneficial when it falls, and likewise is this ummah. It's beneficial that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that its goodness is from beginning to end, indicating that this is one solid connected ummah which has goodness in it from beginning to end." And Imam al-Baylawi said, "Just like rain benefits as it falls, and no one can claim that there's a portion of it or a part of it or a period from it that's not beneficial, and likewise is the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saw him and saw his miracles. And those who came after them believed in him though they didn't see him, and followed into the footsteps of those before them, the companions that is, in good conduct. Those in the beginning founded the nation of Islam, established the foundation for the religion, and those who came after them continued on the path and struggled and strove for the sake of this religion, for the sake of the mission, for the sake of calling people to Allah Azza wa Jalla. So goodness is in it throughout. Before I give the aspect or the aspects of similitude between the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and reign as stated in the narration, two important points must be addressed. Number one is pertaining to reward. You see, during the time of the companions radiallahu anhum, the companions saw Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So things were easier. The companions as a community, as an ummah, all together helped each other, reminding each other with Allah Azza wa Jalla, worked with each other for the sake of the religion. But those who came after them did not. They did not have these means facilitated for them, and thus it is difficult. It is more difficult for them to remain steadfast on the religion. And therefore, they deserved to have their rewards multiplied. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu narrates, and this is reported by Imam al-Tabarani and classified as an authentic narration by another rahmatullahi alayhi. He said, after you, he was addressing the companions, he said, after you, there will come times that require patience and perseverance. The one who holds on, who remains steadfast, will get the reward of 50 martyrs of you. Allahu Akbar. 50 martyrs of the companions. And in the narration that is narrated by Uqba ibn Sa'sa'a radiallahu anhu, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the man who is holding on to his faith and working will get the reward of 50 of you. So one of the people asked, 50 of us or from them? He said, no, rather it is from you. See, there will be no great value for the statement if it was from them. But to highlight the distinguished position and reward they have, he said, from you. Imam al-Nawawi, rahmatullah alayhi, said, this is a reward that can never happen or be obtained by the companions. Why? Because it had to be for those who did not see the Prophet ﷺ after the time of the companions. And because they strove so hard and held on to their faith strongly, they deserved another gift from Allah. Abu Hurairah narrates, and this is in Sahih Muslim, that we were with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day in a graveyard. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, The people said, "Aren't we your brothers?" He said, "No. You are my companions, my brothers, are the people to come." They said, "How can you recognize them on the day of judgment, since you're saying you didn't see them, or they're coming after us?" He said, "I will know them from the trace of wudu. Their face, their hands, and their feet will be bright from the state of wudu. And I will arrive to my fountain before them. وَلَيْذَا أَمَّا مِنْ أُمَّةِ الْرِجَالِ." And some of my people, some of my ummah, will be driven away from my fountain. We ask Allah not to make us among them. They will be prevented from reaching the fountain of the Prophet. And I will be calling them, "Come on, come on." And the angels will say, "You do not know what they did after you. They changed." They changed. They didn't hold on to the faith. They didn't stick to the religion. You don't know what they changed after you, so I say, "Suhan, suhan, murdan, murda. Stay away, stay away." This is a great narration, brothers, and it has glad tidings and a very dangerous threat from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The good news is the honor we can obtain by being his brothers. See, it's a gift that's not going to be given to every individual. It is to some people who are deserving of this. Those who hold on to the faith, those who adhere to the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's enough honor that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is longing to meet such people. Allahu Jannah. And the threat is that if we don't hold on, if we do not adhere to the sunnah, then we're subjecting ourselves to be driven away from the fountain of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Moreover, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed about a people who come after him, who love him more than anything. Abu Hurairah narrated, and it is in Sahih Muslim. He said, "Amongst my ummah are some people who would love me the most. One of them would be willing to sacrifice his family and wealth just to see those who didn't see him. People like us, perhaps we can strive hard to obtain this honor, to be amongst those who love him the most, to be amongst his brothers." Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The second important point regarding the hadith is the virtue of the companions of the Allah. Having said all of this, and having the rewards being multiplied, does not mean by any means that the virtue of those who come after the companions will ever reach the virtue of the companions. See, the companions were the ones who believed when no one believed. They were the ones who supported when there was no support. Those were the ones who struggled. Those who were the ones who were tortured. The number of the believers was little, compared to the hypocrites or the disbelievers. The da'wah wasn't established. The numbers were few. Everybody was surrounding them. But they still remained steadfast. And something which happened to them, which will never happen again, is that they saw the Prophet ﷺ with their own eyes. They touched him, they kissed him, they hugged him. The Prophet ﷺ said, as in Sahih Muslim, narrated by Imran ibn Husayn radiallahu anhu, he said, the best of generations is mine, and then those who come after them, and then those who come after them. This is clear that no one in virtue or no one in rank will be better than these three, and the best of all are the companions. In another incident, also Sahih Muslim, narrated by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was a dispute between amongst the companions, and he said, do not badmouth my companions, for if one of you were to spend as huge as the Mount of Uhud, and the Mount of Uhud is a chain of mountains that occupy a huge spot on earth. When I used to live in Medina, used to drive long ways, 15 minutes by car, in about 5 to 7 minutes on the shorter side. So you can imagine how huge this. He said, if one of you were to spend in gold as huge as the Mount of Uhud, he will not reach the reward of theirs if they spend a handful or half a handful. This is a handful and this is half of it. Now he was addressing companions, comparing them to the senior companions. So how would the case be when we try or attempt to compare the virtue or rank of ours compared to the companions of the Allah? So we must differentiate between the reward and the virtue. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Aspects of similitude between rain and the Muslim nation. Number one is the continuity of steadfastness of this ummah. As rain is beneficial throughout, the ummah is steadfast throughout. And when we talk about the ummah, it's not necessary that we're talking about the ummah entirely fulfilling this. But the Prophet ﷺ said groups, as in this narration that is narrated by Thawban, and it is a Sahih Muslim. He said, a group of my nation will continue steadfast on the truth, victorious by Allah Azza wa Jalla, until the command of Allah comes, meaning until the day of Qiyamah, or until the descent of Isa, in two different explanations to have. So it will continue to remain steadfast. And Allah Azza wa Jalla will continue to support it and give it victory. Now, so the support of Allah Azza wa Jalla can be in terms of enabling them to call for Allah Azza wa Jalla to fulfill the mission of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or to spread knowledge. So it's either da'wah or knowledge. And it can be also in the aspect of jihad, of fighting for the sake of Allah, as in the narration of Uqbah ibn Amr, which is also a Muslim, when he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a group of my nation will continue to fight for the sake of this religion. And Allah will support that. So this is aspect number one. Aspect number two, the continuous revival of this ummah. The Prophet said, and this is reported by Abu Dawood, classed as authentic by Al-Albani, narrated by Abu Hurairah, he said, Allah Azza wa Jalla will continue to send at the end or the beginning, because the Arabic term used, ala raqsi, and raqsi in Arabic can be the beginning or the end of the century, or every 100 years, either the beginning or the end. Those who revive the religion for Ummah. And Imam Sabqari rahmatullah, he said, commenting on revive, he said it is by reviving the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and distinguishing it from bid'ah. Ibn Hajar said about the one or ones, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said many. Men can be a person or a group. He said it's not necessary, true, that Allah will send only one that will revive the religion in all its aspects and fields. It could be different people for different fields of this religion. A group who would revive in hadith, a group who would revive in enjoying good and forbidding evil, a group who would revive the worship of jihad, the people who will revive in the science of tafsir, and so on and so forth. So the second aspect is the continuous revival of the Ummah. And the last aspect I'm going to address today is the continuous strive and effort for the religion of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Abu Inaba al-Khawlani radiallahu anhu narrated, and this is mentioned in the book of Imam al-Majah and classed as Hassan, sound, by Al-Albani rahimahullah. He said Allah Azza wa Jalla will continue to plant in this religion those who will continue to work for the sake of this religion. Allah will continue to plant, so it is throughout the time. Allah will enable a group of people to work for this faith, strive for this religion, call people to it, teach people, revive the Sunnah, fight for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla, persevere through the hardships they will face for their efforts for the deen. They will continue to do that. And finally, I would like to conclude, brothers and sisters, with the following. This narration is telling us that we can be amongst those chosen people in the Ummah throughout the time to obtain all these great rewards and virtues. So what's preventing us? What's stopping me and you from calling for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla? From calling for the path of Allah Azza wa Jalla? What's preventing me and you to memorize the Quran? What's preventing me and you to perform dhikr day and night? What's preventing me and you from commanding our wives, our sisters, our daughters to adhere to proper hijab and know not to go out with their arms showing, part of their hair, makeup, perfume? What's preventing me and you from growing the beard? What's preventing me and you from stopping listening to music? What's preventing me and you from refraining from smoking? What's preventing me and you from virtue and to refrain from any prohibition? What is there that is stopping me and you from reaching this level addressed in this hadith, from reaching this reward, this abundant reward, the reward of 50 companions or 50 martyrs of the companions? What is there? What's the obstacle? It only means sincerity, otherwise. That's all it means. and don't blame Allah Azza wa Jalla. If you don't, that He does not give you. If you don't, that your life becomes miserable, because it's an equation. You do and Allah will give you. It's only fair. You comply and He will support you. He will make your life a bliss. If you refrain, your life will be nothing but miserable. Even if you possess millions and millions, inside is what matters. That's going to be destroyed. So there is nothing stopping us from reaching this level, brothers and sisters. We should have a firm intention right now to change our lives, to make it a better life, to make it a more committed life to Islam. Our lives should be Islam with part-time dunya. The unfortunate thing is that our lives are dunya with not even part-time, whenever we give the time for the sake of religion. إِلَى اللَّهِ شَكْرًا نَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ إِلَى يُؤَخِذَنَا We ask Allah عَزَّ وَجَلَّ not to burden us and not to punish us for our shortcomings and to enable us to sincerely return to Him and work for His faith. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم